Investigators from both the state and federal government will be at work through the night. They'll walk the tracks, measure the accident, look for damage to the roadways and to the rail runner. The family of Carol Donovan and Michael Raffer says they will be grieving. They've lived in the area since before the rail runner started making its daily trips. They say they see a clear need for crossing arms at the rail crossings. The state, so far, has not agreed. The crossing at Miller Road and 314 is what's called a private crossing.
Private crossings are crossings that were granted to individual residents by the railroad company because they wanted to have quicker access onto major roadway facilities.
Trains are required to sound horns near crossings, something state police and soon federal investigators will check.
Actually, we do a lot of accidents involving railroads in this particular area. It's not really new to us.
The family says the crossing isn't new to them either, and they want a change.
This particular one, we will go back and reevaluate simply because of what happened tonight, but also to see if there is a need to maybe look at some other consolidation of crossings in the future.
Carol Donovan's family and Michael Raffers says even if that change comes, it'll come too late.